Then we're going to be working with graphing fractions and decimals. Basically, we've done this with integers, and we've put the number and its opposite. Now we're going to be doing it with decimals or the real numbers. On this particular lesson, I will have you guys put the numbers that are around it. I would rather, instead of you do the problems like example one, I'll kind of show you how I'd rather have you do this example. So on number one here, we have 3/4 that we're supposed to graph and its opposite. So what I would rather have you do, and I'll draw it kind of shorter over here to the right hand or the left hand side, I would like you to put 0 and then 1. So the integers that are around the number, and then put the correct side of the number that it's on. So 3/4, positive 3/4 would be just short of being 1. So positive 3/4 would be about here. And then I would like you to, on the other side, understand how far over negative 3/4 is. Well, it's 3/4 of the way to 1, to negative 1 on the other side. So that's where it is. This distance should be the same every time when we graph opposites. Now again, it's going to be a rough picture, but what I don't want you to do is mistakenly put negative 3/4 somewhere past 1 or somewhere too close to 0. So negative 3/4 shouldn't be that close to 0. It should be closer to 1. Really, as long as you have it close to where it should be, you guys should be fine in this lesson. I just want you guys to show that you have some number sense in this lesson. Negative 1.6 and positive 1.6, again, I'll kind of draw a number line below it here. So we're going to have to go clear out to negative 2 and clear up to positive 2. So I need positive 1, I need 0, and I need negative 1 in my graph. Again, negative 1.6 is the first one we graph, so we're going to go past 1.5. It's a little bit closer to the 2 than it is the 1. That's negative 1.6 right there. And positive 1.6 would also be a little bit closer to positive 2 than it is to positive 1, so it should be about right there. Again, this lesson is just working with number sense, you guys. So take some time to try these on your own. I'll draw the number line here for you. You guys will have to draw one on your own for your notes, but this should be not that hard to do. I'll try and put them all on one for you here, but for the most part, we should be able to do this pretty easily. Again, I had to squeeze my number line together a little bit. You guys can kind of plan yours out a little bit better. Hopefully, it won't be too bad. On quizzes and tests, you guys, I'll give you a number line, so don't worry about it. But as far as this homework goes, you should have a rough approximation. I'll try and kind of change the colors. For number one, we have 2.5, so we need to go to 2. And then right between 2 and 3, so positive 2.5 will go orange. For this one, I'll circle it in orange. And then negative 2.5 would be right about here. Okay, the next one, I'll do it in red. Negative 4 over 5 would be almost clear to negative 1. Positive 405 would be almost clear to positive 1, so right about there. The next one, let's do it in blue. Negative 3.5. So I have, again, that's right between negative 3 and negative 4. Its opposite would be right between positive 3 and positive 4. Last one here, we'll do it in green, 5.25. The positive one is 5 and 1/4. It should be closer to the 5 than the 6. For negative 5 and 1/4, again, it should be closer to the 5 than the 6. So again, notice that all of the colors that match are the same distance from 0. For these examples in your homework, all you have to do is put a less than or a greater than sign between the two numbers. So for example, your homework problem will look like this. And you're supposed to put less than, greater than, or equal to. 1/2 is closer to 0 than negative 3/4, so this answer would be greater than. The next one, negative 4 and 5/6, and negative 4 and 1/6. Again, we're going for the numbers, when they are negative, we're going for the numbers that are closer to 0. 5/6 is farther away than 0 than 1/6 is, and they both have the same whole number in front of the mixed number. So again, you just have to look at the fractions. 5 is farther than 1 when it's negative. So we're going to put less than for the answer on this one. comparing numbers on this one, you guys, we will do this these types of problems on a number line. You're not going to be just given two. You're going to be given several. We'll probably see an example like that. But the ones like this, what I want you to do is put the two numbers that are they are closest to. So, for example, negative 3.8 is closest to negative 4, and negative 3.08 is closest to negative 3. And notice here in the picture, they have 3.08 isn't even quite negative 3.1, and negative 3.8 is farther to the left. It's almost negative 4. So, again, a rough sketch of this. Negative 3.8 would be about right here. Negative 3.1 would be about right there. Again, they did it really well in their number line picture. I liked the way they did this because they used those tenths, because that's what the closest unit of measurement is to all of them. And then they said, okay, negative 3.08 is greater. This one is greater over here because it's closer to positive numbers. It's closer to zero. Okay, we have a real-world example here. It says the Chinook wind is a warm mountain wind that can cause rapid temperature changes. The table shows three of the greatest temperature drops ever recorded after Chinook wind occurred. On which date did the temperature drop the fastest, and explain? So we're looking for the biggest change in temperature. Well, we're looking here on January 10th, it went negative 3.3 1/10 degrees per minute. And then November 10th, it went negative 5/8 degrees per minute. And on January 22nd, negative 2 1/5 degrees per minute. So when it's looking for the farthest left, we want negative 3 1/10. So your answer for this one is going to be, again, the biggest change would be that one, farthest away from zero. Again, these are examples that you're going to try on your own. Number 8, it's saying the same problem, but they're saying, what if the greatest change in temperature was negative 3 2/5? It says a temperature of 3 2/5 is recorded. Is that change the greatest temperature? So they're basically asking the question on number 8. They're asking this question. Is negative 3 2/5 greater than negative 3 1/10? And you guys can just put yes or no for number 8. Numbers 5, 6, and 7, go ahead and pause and try those. Okay, so for number 5, we should put less than. Number 6, we should put greater than. Number 7, we should put less than. And number 10, you're going to say yes. Negative 3 2/5 is a farther change from zero. This number is less than the other one. So that one's the farthest change. Okay, so this is the end of the video. Make sure you guys go ahead and look at the schedule for your homework. Also, after this lesson, we do have a quiz. So make sure you guys go through that study guide for the quiz. It's going to be on page 265 or 266, the study guide for the quizzes.